Time for Corner Table. It's our theater review segment. The segment features legendary critic John Simon and newcomer Justin Brown. Simon wrote for New York Magazine for more than 35 years and has also been featured in the New York Times and Washington Post, among others. Justin is an actor and a director who's really just getting started in the critic game. And tonight they are looking at the Tony Award-winning musical Bandstand.
Hey, John.
Hi.
How you doing?
Not too bad.
I like that. So me and John are here at Joe Allen. We're going to talk to you today about Bandstand. What did you think about Bandstand?
I liked it very much. I think it deserves much higher praise and much more success than seems to be indicated at this point. It does a very interesting thing in that it has actors who can all play various instruments constituting a jazz band, and they do just as well by their instrument as they do by their acting. And this is not like John Doyle doing foolish things, which we don't need. And it has a wonderful leading lady, Laura Osnes, who is one of the prettiest and most charming and most delightful singing actresses we have. The only one is another Laura, by the way. It has a very decent basic set that sort of works. It doesn't make for the set changes which the text actually calls for, but what the hell. It does have a very lively direction. Shall we tell them who the director is?
Absolutely. So the director is Andy Blackenbuehler, who choreographed Hamilton.
Yeah, so he is one of the real true choreographer directors. Mm-hmm. He can do both equally well, just as the people on stage can act and play their instruments. He can direct and devise very unusual, original, different looking choreography. It doesn't look like anybody else's. It's acrobatic, it's alive. It moves. It's always there in a way that isn't obtrusive and yet isn't to be overlooked either. And it has a fairly decent score by a man called Richard Oberacker, who apparently is well known in Europe, but who hasn't become well known here. One would like to think that this would establish him, but so far, the reviews have not been very encouraging.
Which is really upsetting. I think that Oberacker's music is very interesting. It follows a great formula that I think balances traditional musical theater composition and the move into a more contemporary sound that's been happening on Broadway. Oberacker's music has really opened up Laura Osnes' voice in a way that we really haven't heard her sing before, which is really exciting as well. The end of Act One is absolutely stunning and hair-raising. I think that the saddest thing for me about Bandstand is that I heard a review that said that Come From Away is the catharsis that America needs. And in reality, I think that Bandstand is the catharsis that America needs. It's talking about veterans, it's talking about politics, it's talking about the issues that people face in everyday life that we will never be able to understand as mere civilians. And so I think that Bandstand definitely needs a lot more attention than it's getting, and it's highly unfortunate.
There's something ironic about the fact that a show whose music is jazz of the 40s should be the most contemporary show there is, but that's how it works out. Theater has these paradoxes, and this is one of them.
Absolutely. So, naturally, I'm telling everybody to go see Bandstand. Go support them. It's an incredible show. It really speaks to the American subconscious and what we should be talking about right now, what we should always be talking about. John, do you agree?
Yes. I think we should mention the leading man in
Corey Bandstand,
because he is pretty damn good, too. And between them, he and Osnes are a very charming couple, and you root for them. And when they get really together in the end, it's a truly good, uplifting feeling.
Well, I completely disagree with that.
You do?
I do. But we'll have to talk about that at another time. Thank you, guys.
And thank you. We'll take a break. When we come back, our Hudson Valley headlines.